Sometimes we really do need to let go. This week's Torah reading is B'shalach, meaning when he let go. Referring to, after all the drama that led up to this, when the Pharaoh finally let our people go. Just as our path to get to this point of reattaining our freedom was not the shortest path, our exodus was also not the shortest path. There was a more direct route we could have taken, but God led us on a longer route, in part to avoid going through the land of the Philistines, but also in part to try and help us better build our faith and not so question our faith, to have us take more steps towards who and how we could and should become. Sometimes the shortest path is not the best, most desirable for longer-term goals. After we left, however, Pharaoh had a change of heart. And with his heart hardened again, he gathered his chariots and rallied his officers and came after us. When we saw this, as later in this parsha when we were thirsty, and as later in this parsha when we were hungry, many of our ancestors cried out to Moses and questioned whether we would have been better to have stayed slaves in Egypt than to possibly die in the wilderness. We still had the mindset of slaves. We were not ready yet to understand, to appreciate, and to well exist as a free people. And that ultimately, in part, leads us to wander in the desert for 40 years. For this generation of slaves to give rise to a generation born in freedom who will be the ones to redevelop our people as a free people back in our promised land. Here we are, though, on our journey, and we are afraid of Pharaoh and his officers who are in pursuit of us. But we really needed to better build faith in God who was leading us with a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. And Moses proclaimed to us, Al tira'u, have no fear. Hityatzvu, stand by. Uru et Yeshuat, witness the deliverance. Adonai Asher Yaseh Lachem, the Lord will work for you. Adonai Yilachem Lachem, the Lord will battle for you. V'atem Tacharishun, and you hold your peace. We needed to build the quiet confidence that can actually, in and of itself, be a form of prayer. We needed our fear turned into faith. There is the story of the little boy, Nachshon, the epitome of faith. As when we were faced with the great sea in front of us and the Egyptians coming from behind, and as many of our ancestors were questioning if we should have stayed slaves in Egypt, and maybe even now go back. Little Nachshon was said to have faith and to step forward into the sea, one step at a time, until the water level was at his nostrils, and the sea began to part. As it was then, as instructed by God, that Moses raised his staff and held it out over the great sea in front of us, and God parted the sea. And Nachshon's faith was validated, and our faith grew enough that we too stepped forward and progressed to the other side. As Pharaoh and his officers pursued and followed us into the sea, as we made it to safety, the sea closed in on them. As this parasha states, the Egyptians would know, Ki ani Adonai, that I am the Lord. Vayosha Adonai bayom hahu et Yisrael miad Mitzrayim. Thus the Lord delivered Israel that day from the Egyptians. Vayira'u ha'am et Adonai, and the people feared the Lord. Vaya'aminu b'Adonai, and they had faith in the Lord. With our making it to the other side, most of the rest of this parsha is praiseful singing of song. Shirat Hayam, Song of the Sea, the longest poem in the Chumash. Moses proclaimed and sang, Ashirah la'Adonai ki ga'oga'ah, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. It is from this song that we take the words we include in our regular tefillot as the Micha Mocha prayer.
Micha Mocha ba'elim Adonai.
Who is like you, O Lord, among the celestials?
Mi kamocha nedar bakodesh.
Who is like you, majestic in holiness?
No ratilok o sefele.
Awesome in splendor, working wonders. And it builds up to
Adonai Yimloch Le'olam va'ed.
The Lord will reign forever and ever. No Pharaoh or other such mortal king is even but a fraction. But God is the sovereign king. Not only did Moses sing, but Miriam sang. It even states in this parsha that Miriam, the prophetess, took a timbrel in her hand, and all the women followed her, just as she had planned. These are not just lyrics to an empowering song written in more recent years, 1989, by Debbie Friedman, but these are words actually in this Torah reading. A question many have understandably asked, though, is that if we were in such a hurry to pack, if we were only able to carry so much for such a journey, and in fact a long journey ahead, why did Miriam and others pack musical instruments like her timbrel, tambourine? And the answer is particularly poignant and profound. We should be prepared to sing, and we should be prepared to celebrate. No matter how challenging the times we may face, no matter how difficult the journey ahead, we need to be prepared. We need to know that there will be times for celebration ahead. And with that, I will leave you ready to celebrate Shabbat. And I wish you the Shabbat Shalom.